I would like to talk a little bit about the any book that you probably have got. If you don't have it yet, there are some copies outside, which is called The Climate Knowledge Broker's Manifesto. We have written that book, or we have worked on that book around one and a half years ago. The reason for that was that we came together in a group, and in the group we said, look, there is a huge challenge coming up in terms of this knowledge brokering role. But what we need to do in the group is to come together and start discussing the role of the knowledge broker, starting to describe what is important, and starting to write something that we can use to also describe that important role of the knowledge brokers to others. So we have done this manifesto together, and this was quite a collaborative effort of 90 interviews being done and so on. And I'd like to point out some of the highlights of the manifesto. I've gone through the reason why we did this, so let me start with the manifesto itself. So the first thing that we had to do is to create a vision for that group. For the Climate Knowledge Brokers Group, the overall vision that we have is that there has to be a world in which people can make climate-sensitive decisions based on the best available climate knowledge. So people who are working on climate change issues deserve to have the best available information to their hand. And that means that we have to work together to provide that to them. And as said, in the book, we describe the role of knowledge brokers. So, first thing here is, what is a climate knowledge broker? How do we define this? And that was quite a discussion in the group, as you can imagine, because everyone describes a knowledge broker in a different way. But we came up with a definition which you will find in the book. We heard yesterday also in the panel some other ways to describe it, which I also like, in terms of being intermediaries, being translators, being knowledge facilitators. So this is all roles of knowledge brokers. I would like to show you some of the key graphics that we have in the book, because they are a good starting point for our discussions that we're going to have. The first one is about user needs, and that is what we heard from all the interviews that we have done. User needs first. So let's start always with asking ourselves, what is the need of the user that we want to provide that knowledge to? And that's not an easy thing. That sounds super simple and totally makes sense to all of us. But when we remember discussions that we had in previous knowledge broker workshops, very often we had participants who came to say, look, I got a project, I have to do a platform because that's part of my project, and we have kind of pre-selected a software to do this, so how can we make it better? And then asking the question about actually who is it for is something that is a very tricky one to answer. And that's because very often there's not enough time, there's not enough possibilities to think about that before we go into the process of starting to create knowledge brokering tools. So we put this user needs very, very much up front in the knowledge broker manifesto. And we grouped it not along the usual archetypes of users. You hear about normally when you ask about what's your users, you think of policymakers, journalists, extension workers or so. But we tried to group it in a different way, where we said, what's the issue for the user? And that ranged from some people are just not aware of the issue of climate change, to there is a lack of quality information, there's information that's hidden and they can't get to it, it's not tailored to their needs, or it's just simply too much. And knowledge brokers play quite an essential role in overcoming these issues by doing various different things, which we describe in the book and which we will also work on during this workshop. They will come back and back again. So the ultimate aim is that by playing the role, or by doing the role of the knowledge broker in an effective way, we overcome these issues for the users and we make them able to get the information that they need to work on climate change issues. So how is this done? Well, the main thing that we heard from these interviews is it is all about tailored information. We need to give these users the information that they need in a way that is tailored to their needs. And that works in various different ways, and we've just picked three very important ones here in that graphic. We said, well, the first one is about synthesizing climate information, bringing it together from various different sources. Second one is about contextualizing with the sectoral information that those people are working in. The if you give them information just about, you know, here it is, without giving a context to the sector they're working in, it's very often very hard for them to use. And the third one is about enriching it with local information. I think that's quite a challenge very often, but it's very important. The third graphic I want to show you as an excerpt from the book is about the role of the knowledge brokers, because we also have thought about what actually is the role of climate knowledge brokers and what are the dimensions of this role. And we've asked this to about 90 people, and we came up with some conclusions from these interviews. And the first one that is very important for us to convey always when we talk about this is actually knowledge brokers are part of the chain. Yeah? It's very rare that a knowledge broker just sits in between of those who produce the knowledge, like the information and data, like the scientist, and those who consume it. Just being the one person organization in between those two, that's a very rare case. Normally, you are much in a kind of a chain of knowledge brokers who broker the knowledge from one to another, to another, to another. And it's important for people who play, who act in this role as a knowledge broker in an effective way, to know where in this chain they are, because you have to know with whom you need to talk on the left-hand side and on the right-hand side, so on the producer side and on the consumer side. The second one, which we were told is essential, that knowledge brokers should act in a way that they are filters and interfaces for climate knowledge. We can go into a deep discussion about what that means and what the risks are in here, but let's keep that for the sessions, for the interactive sessions. And the third one is that knowledge brokers always act in different disciplines and fields. So a knowledge broker never is going to be in just one very specific field. They will have to interact with lots of different fields and sectors. So how about the CKB group? How do we fit into that picture? Well, the CKB group as group is acting on the principle of sharing and collaboration. And that's what we're doing here, and you'll see more of that within the next coming 2 days. But basically, we can describe the CKB group to act in two different ways. The first one is the community of practice. Well, you're here, you're part of this community of practice, and that's great. And the second one is about, we said, state-of-the-art digital tools, services, and products. This is about creating the frameworks, creating the possibilities to actually enable knowledge brokers to be more effective. And we'll have some sessions during this workshop to work on this too. So the three main messages that we got from the interviews and that are part of the manifesto is, first one is scale. Nowadays, almost everyone is becoming a consumer of climate information. So there's a huge scale challenge in here. The second one is, I mentioned that already, is tailoring. We need to be able to tailor information to the needs of the users. And the third one is, we will only be able to meet this and to be able to support users to get tailored information in the extent it's needed if we work together. So how does this all relate to this workshop that we are here for and the topic that we're going to discuss? And Jeff will just say a few words on next steps of Jason. For us, after launching the manifesto, we got a lot of feedback. And one of the main things that we heard is, that's great, that's really important to write it down, but how do we actually become more effective in this? And so based on that feedback that we got, we started to think about capacity building and how to build the capacity of knowledge brokers and how to enhance the capacity. And that's part of the theme of this workshop, and we want to work with you on this, on enhancing this idea, on further developing it with your input